You say, well, our church ain't in the Bible. I don't see where in the Bible that the Methodist church is there. And he'll say, well, it's there. You're just not getting it. Well, show me where it is, preacher. Well, what you need to understand, you've been talking to somebody, and they're trying to mess with you. And see, don't take me over there. Show me where it is, preacher. Now, if you'll insist on it, he's going to have to tell you, well, it's not there per se. Well, see, I just came from over at Lawrence Avenue, the Church of Christ, and they showed me in Romans chapter 16 where the churches of Christ salute you. They showed me in Matthew 16 where Christ said, I'll build my church. They showed me in Ephesians chapter 1 where Christ is the head of the church, the body. Christ. And he showed me in Colossians chapter 1 where he's the head of the body, the church. Amen. They showed me in the Bible where they're there. Why can't you show me? See, if you'll be, sometimes they try to say we dogmatic. But the truth is, you need to be dogmatic because your soul is at stake. If you want to get to heaven, you better get dogmatic because you know what? The devil is dogmatic. Ain't nobody trying to tell him not to be dogmatic. Ain't nobody trying to tell the devil not to keep trying to push stuff down our throat. Get up in the morning on the radio, all you hear is junk. Coming straight from the devil. Turn on the TV and all you get is junk. Coming straight from the devil. Get to work and the person next to you, he ain't talking nothing but junk because he's working with the devil. The devil is pushing stuff down your throat every day. And all I'm trying to get you to say, look at the word of God. If you look at the word of God, you'll find out there's only one place that a man can be saved. There's only one place that a woman can be saved. And it's in the body of Christ. Again, denominations, where are they from? Are they from heaven or from man? If they're from heaven, they ought to be in this book. For the Bible tells us that all scripture is given by inspiration. It holds all things pertaining to life, to godliness. If you want to know what God wants for you, if you want to know where God wants you to be, if you want to know how God wants you to worship, if you want to know what God wants to be happy in your life, you can't go to a catechism. You can't go to a discipline. You can't go to a Book of Mormon. You can't go to no Jehovah's, what they call them, door knocker things. I forget what they call them. But you can't go to that stuff. You got to go to the Bible. And if it ain't in the Bible, you need to run from it. Amen. You need to run from it. So the question now is, okay, brother preacher, I hear what you're saying, and I even got a grasp of what you're saying, but what you haven't told me is how do I fix this problem that I've got? I'm in this denominational church, and I don't know what to do. Do I go talk to my preacher about it? Well, I just told you. You're going to be spinning your wheels if you go talk to your preacher. Why? Because his business is yours. If you leave, he's losing. So he ain't going to tell you, yeah, that man was telling you the truth. You need to go on and get your life right. Because if he tell you that, he got to tell the other 400 people that. Y'all don't mind if I come down there, do you? You gotta understand that you need to go to the Word of God. God will tell you what you need to do to fix your problems. If you want salvation, if you want to have eternal life, if you want to be able to lay your head on your pillow tonight and not worry whether tomorrow is going to come, that you're going to be right with God and in his presence if he should return, then first of all, you need to do what you've done today. You need to come and hear the gospel. The Bible tells us that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, Romans chapter 10 and verse number 17. You can't read Jack and the Beanstalk and find salvation. You can't read some religious novel. You know, you can't read T.D. Jakes' book. Amen. All right? Mm-hmm. And think it's going to get you to heaven. Because first, T.D. Jakes got to get himself right. Amen. Well, he's a good man. I told you about good folk. His work is lawlessness. He's working outside the law of God, man. Telling folk to come down and say a prayer and be saved. The man's a liar. I'll tell him to his face. Y'all say, well, y'all, you ain't gonna never see him. You don't know. You don't know. Maybe if you see him, you tell him Brother Brinkley called him a liar. And if he want to fix it, tell him, come on. He got enough money. He can come to me. I ain't got that kind of money. He done belked all them folk out of money. Tell him to come to me. Yeah, that's right. That's right. But he's a liar. And you can't be reading his book and think it'll get you to heaven. You got to go to the Word of God. That's where you got to go. After you've heard the gospel, you need to believe the same. The Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 11, without faith, it's impossible to please God. You can't please God and not believe that he is. Jesus said, if you believed in God, believe also in me. You got to have faith. Without faith, you can't please. It doesn't matter what else you do. You can't please God if you don't have faith. Now, this is not just the faith that folks say, you know, just accept the Lord as your Savior. That kind of faith don't work. See, it's the faith that causes you to obey. It's the faith that motivates you to obey. And what will it make you do? It'll make you repent. It'll make you change. It'll make you turn your way. Repentance is utmost importance. If you want salvation, you got to change from who you used to be and start acting like who you ought to be. You got to give up false religion and come to true religion. Jesus said it like this, except you repent, you shall all likewise perish, Luke chapter 13. And you know what? It doesn't take God but once to say something and we ought to jump on it. But if Jesus repeats himself, you ought to listen. Because he said it twice. Just back to back. Except you repent, you're all going to perish. Now, if Jesus had to say it twice, it wasn't just because he was trying to make a point. I think he was trying to help us understand that's probably the toughest thing for a lot of us to do. We don't like to be wrong. Amen. We don't like to have to say I'm wrong. We don't like to have to admit I'm wrong. You can get caught with your hand in the cookie jar, cookies all over your mouth, and say, what? I ain't done nothing. I didn't eat that. I was just tasting it. Don't want to be wrong. But except you repent, you're going to perish. Repent of your sins. Repent of your past. Somebody says, I'm a good person. That's not the problem. The problem is you haven't surrendered to Christ. And you need to repent. Mm-hmm. Then confess Jesus openly and publicly. Even today. Even now. I wish it were like it was back in the first century when preachers would be preaching. Apostles would be preaching, and in the middle of their message, somebody recognized, I need to be fixed. Yes, sir. They didn't wait for the invitation song. Mm-hmm. We got in condition, but that's okay. If the Lord allows you to wait till the invitation song, don't wait no longer. Amen. Confess Jesus openly and publicly that he is the Son of God. In that same book of Matthew chapter 16, early in the chapter, about verse 1 or 2, Jesus asked, who do men say that I am? He said, who do men say that I am? And Peter said, well, some of them say you this, and some of them say you that. He said, wait a minute, Peter, I ain't asking you that. I said, who do you think I am? Peter finally came around and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus went on to say, if you will confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father, which is in heaven. If you want salvation, you're going to have to confess Jesus. Amen. He said, but if you deny me before men, I'm going to deny you before my Father, which is in heaven. I tell people all the time, I don't want to hear Jesus say, I don't know you. So I'm going to confess him before anybody that want to hear it. And some folk that don't want to hear it, going to hear it. Because I want to be sure that he heard me. Yes, you ought to be sure that he's heard you make that confession. See, a lot of folks want to go to heaven on the down low. You can't get there like that. Right. There ain't going to be no closet Christians. You know, you're either going to be a Christian or you're not. Right. You're either going to confess him or you're not. Amen. And believe me, if you don't confess him, you automatically are denying him. when this invitation is extended as it's being, and you have an opportunity to walk and come out and give your life to Christ, and you stand there and do nothing and try to reason with the devil, because he's going to be talking to you. He's going to be in your head trying to tell you, you don't need to do that. Don't pay no attention to that guy. They paid him to do that. They ain't gave me nothing. Not yet, anyway. I'm just saying. I'm just trying to make it. My wife tell me, don't do that. But seriously, I'm not in it for the money. Amen. I've never asked for a penny to preach the gospel. I never will. If folk love me, they love me. But if they don't, that's all right. Because I'm preaching for the glory of God. Amen. So it ain't like I'm trying to get paid for a head here or a head there. That's not the case. The thing is, I want all to be saved. And if you don't confess Jesus, you're going to stand there and argue with the devil till the man say you may be seated, and you're going to walk out of here with your sins yet on you, and Satan is going to do everything he can for the next few days until you leave this earth to try to hasten your demise. We had a young lady was tragically taken away. Just last week, and the first thought of most people is, why would God let somebody take somebody? The devil taking folk. See, the devil's that's his power. Death is his power. And one day God's going to conquer death. He conquered it for him. He's going to conquer it for you. But right now the devil's trying to get you, and he wants to get you outside of Christ, because outside of Christ there's no life. You need to be in him. So you've heard the truth. Do you believe it? Are you willing to repent of your sins and confess Jesus to be the Son of God? That's not tough, is it? If you'll do that, then you can go down in the watery grave of baptism for the remission of your sins. Acts chapter 2 and verse 38, when Peter and the other 11 began to preach the gospel, and these people heard it, said, men, what shall we do? Peter said, repent and be baptized, 12 of y'all. No, he said, every one of you. That means you and me, everybody. If you want salvation, you need to be baptized for the remission of your sins. I say that because a lot of people say, well, I've been baptized. I was baptized, you know, because back when I got saved, I asked God in my heart, and then we went, I remember it well, it was the third Sunday. We all went and got baptized. Well, my question is, why would you need to be baptized? If baptism is for salvation, and you already say why you need to be baptized. It don't, see, when you think about it, it really don't make any real sense at all, does it? Because it's a game that they play. Folks play a game with your soul. And they don't let you hear what God has to say. And it gets you caught up in this stuff. And then the next thing you know, it's judgment. And Jesus is saying, depart from me. I never knew you. You can stop that today. You can fix that today. God is giving you a wonderful opportunity, and he doesn't owe it to you. He does it because he loves you. He may not ever give you another opportunity. He does it because he loves you. He went through all of the trouble of making sure you got here safely today so you could hear the truth, hoping that you would obey it. Are you here today and not a member of the body of Christ? This invitation is to you. We want you to come. We want you to come and give your life to Christ. Not to man. Give it to Christ. Amen. Let him have control of your life today. It begins today if you'll take advantage of it. If you're a child of God, you've obeyed the gospel and not been walking faithfully, shame on you. You need to repent. You need to repent, and you need to do it today. Amen. Confess your fault. That is, agree with God. I'm talking about getting up telling God everything. He already knows what you've done. Amen. You need to agree that you've done it. See, that's the problem. We don't like to agree that we've done it. Well, he know my heart. That's the problem. He know your heart. Amen. You need to repent, and you need to ask for the prayers of the church. Yes. God will forgive you. He's willing to forgive his children. He wants to forgive his children. He let his son die so his blood can cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So why not take advantage? We're going to sing a song of encouragement, and we're going to ask you to come right now as together we stand and sing.
And you are
there one this morning. One this morning, willing and